Dear children, Sai Ram. In the last class, we studied degrees of comparison. In today's class, we will learn verbs. Action verbs. Now, what are action verbs, children? Well, read the following sentences to understand action verbs. Okay. Now, the first sentence, my father works in a factory. Lena drinks milk. Meena wrote a letter to her mother. Okay, children. Now, in the above sentences, the highlighted words show the actions done or performed by the father in the first sentence, Lena in the second sentence, and Meena in the third sentence. So, what do you understand by this? We understand that the words works, drinks, and wrote are action words. So, they are called action verbs. Okay, children, now let's understand what are saying verbs. Saying means to say something or tell something. Let's read the following sentences. I'll buy you a football for your birthday. Father promised. Seema, you are always late, shouted the teacher. Okay, children, now in the above sentences also, the highlighted words promised and shouted are saying verbs. Now, what do they show? They show how people express their feelings. So, these words are just alternative verbs for said. So, they are known as saying verbs. So, now what are being verbs? Okay, let's understand what are being verbs. Let's read the following sentences. I am a girl. Saroj is 5 years old. They are best friends. It was too cold yesterday. They were very happy. Okay, now well, let's understand what the highlighted words are called. The highlighted words in the above sentences am, is, are, was, and were are called as being verbs. Being verb means it's a verb that shows a state of being. It emphasizes how the noun or subject is. Subject is, was, or will be, and shows how something looks or feels. Okay. We also understand that they are used with other verbs like in the examples. Now, look at the examples. Birds are flying in the sky. Seema is sleeping. So, here the being verbs are used with flying. Flying is also an action verb. Seema is sleeping. So, here is a being verb and it is used with the action verb sleeping. Okay, now let's see what are having verbs. Read the following sentences, children. Meera has breakfast every day in the morning. Second sentence, we have won the game. I had a pet in my native place. So here we understand that in the above sentences, the highlighted words has, have, and had are used as verbs. Hence, they are called having verbs. Having verb means the verb have has the forms have, has, having. Okay, so have has three forms. Have, has, having. And the base form of the verb is have. The present participle is having, meaning to own or possess something. So it emphasizes how the noun or subject owns or possesses something. Okay, now let's come to the helping verbs. Let's read the following sentences. Our family is flying to America. The students are working hard. He has been waiting for his bus. So let's understand, children, that helping means to help someone. Okay? Helping means to help someone. So in the above sentences, the words is, are, and has been have been highlighted because they are helping verbs. There are some verbs which help other verbs to do their work. So together they make a verb group. Now here's a list of some of the helpers or helping verbs which help other verbs do their work. So together they make a verb group. Okay, so when they are teamed up with other verbs, they are called helping verbs. Okay, memorize these verbs very well, children. So which are these helpers or which are the helping verbs? Am, is, are, was, were, be, being, been, do, does, did, have, had, shall, will, can, must, may, might, could, would, should. Okay, now here's an important note, children. Sometimes a verb is separated from its helper. For example, I have often seen him here. Did you go home early? So in the above sentences, we can find the verbs seen and go are separated from their helpers, and have and did. Okay, these verbs are not placed together, they are separated. Okay, now let's come to another important topic, that is verbs tenses. What is a tense, children? Tense is the time described by a verb as to when an action has been performed. Let's read the following sentences. My mother cooks food. My mother cooked food. My mother shall or will cook food. In the above sentences, children, the highlighted words cooks, cooked, and shall, will cook show the action of the noun mother, which is a subject here. So they are verbs. In the first sentence, the word cooks indicates the present action of the mother. So it is said to be in the simple present tense. In the second sentence, the verb cooked indicates that the action is already done. Therefore, it is said to be in simple past tense. In the third sentence, the verb will, shall cook, indicates that the action will take place in the future. Therefore, it is said to be in the simple future tense. Now, let's solve some activities based on all the verbs and verb tenses to understand the concept better. Okay, so what do we have in this activity, children? We have to underline the action verbs. Okay, read the sentence. First sentence is, my mother baked a cake for me. I repeat the sentence, my mother baked a cake for me. So here, which is the action verb, children? Which word shows you that there is an action performed? Yes, baked. So the action verb here is baked. Second sentence, the earth rotates on its own axis. I repeat, the earth rotates on its own axis. Yes. So here the action verb is rotates. Okay, now what activity we have here? Which activity do we have here? Underline the saying verbs. Okay, so in the first sentence we have, I have not broken the vase, cried Tara. I repeat, I have not broken the vase, cried Tara. So here, which is the saying verb? Saying verbs are the verbs which say something or tell something. Okay, so here, cried. Cried is the saying verb. Second sentence, I'm really sorry, sobbed Tony. I'm really sorry, sobbed Tony. Yes, so here the saying verb is sobbed. Next, what do here, which activity do we have? Underline the being verbs. Being verbs means a verb which shows the state of being. So the first sentence is, the child was crying bitterly. The child was crying bitterly. So here the being verb is was. Very good. Second sentence, I am writing a letter. I am writing a letter. Am. So here the being verb is am. Next activity, underline the having verbs. First sentence, the students have gone home. The students have gone home. So which is the having verb here, children? Have. Okay, so here the having verb is have. Second sentence, we had a wonderful time. We had a wonderful time. Yes, so here the having verb is had. Okay, now here we have, which activity do we have? We have complete the sentences by using helping verbs. Okay, so your first sentence, I told you to memorize the helping verbs. Okay, so your, which helping verb you will write? First sentence, you dash see him tomorrow. First sentence, you dash see him tomorrow. Yes, so which helping verb will come? Might. You might see him tomorrow. Second sentence, all assignments dash be submitted by Monday. All assignments dash be submitted by next Monday. Yes. Which helping verb? Must. All assignments must be submitted by next Monday. Okay, now next activity we have. Underline the verbs and state whether they are in the simple present tense, simple past tense, or simple future tense. First sentence, we go to school. We go to school. So here you have to first underline the verb and then you have to state the tense. Okay, so here which is the verb first? Go. Go is the verb. And which is the tense? Simple present tense. Okay. Second sentence. Kiran refused to help me yesterday. Kiran refused to help me yesterday. Yes, so here which is the verb? Refused. Refused is the verb. And which is this tense? It is in the simple past tense. Okay, next. My teacher will tell us a story on Monday. My teacher will tell us a story on Monday. Yes, children? So, here will tell is the verb. And which is the tense? It is in the simple future tense. Next sentence, the stones sank quickly in the water. The stones sank quickly in the water. Here the verb is sank. And the tense is simple past tense. Next, my sister does her work very neatly. My sister does her work very neatly. Here the verb is does and it is in the simple present tense. Okay, next sentence. The students of class 4 will bring their maths book tomorrow. The students of class 4 will bring their maths book tomorrow. So here the verb is will bring and it is in the simple future tense. Okay children, now with that I suppose you have understood what are action verbs, what are saying verbs, what are being verbs, what are having verbs and what are helping verbs. And also understood verbs tenses, that is simple present tense, simple past tense and simple future tense. Now next class I will teach you all continuous present tense, continuous tense or present progressive tense. Till then, revise all that I have taught you all in this class. Thank you, children.